We've made it to Labor Day weekend, although some of us are still working right now as I'm recording this, but who cares? It's Thursday. We have real football tonight. We have Ohio State playing a game, and Tennessee is going to attempt to play football, which should be entertaining for some of you people who have sick fetishes out there watching that team play. But regardless, we're here. So football tonight, football tomorrow, football Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. Oh, it feels good to be here. It really does. So a couple things. The OU depth chart was released late yesterday, so I decided to wait and talk about it today. Not too many surprises. I mean, shock of all shocks, Spencer Rattler, QB1. Am I right? So running back, it was interesting to look at. Graham Brooks, obviously your 1 and 2. Rolling with Todd Hudson and Knowles as your OR candidates for 3 and 4. So we're going with the walk-ons, apparently. So hold on to your butts for that one, guys. H-back Jeremiah Hall, Brandon Willis, Austin Stogner, no shock there. Your starting receivers appear to be Hazelwood, Mims, and Mike Woods, you know. So, you know, the transfer from Arkansas, hearing a lot of good things about him. I'm looking forward to seeing him play. So if Theo's going to be out for a little bit, for a couple weeks, then, you know, good chance to see Mike Woods play. You know, he's kind of like a guy that people forget, and go sub his channel. He's got a channel. He's got a channel on YouTube. Go sub it. But yeah, looking forward to that. And Amara Williams is right behind him. I'm sure he's going to get involved at some point. And maybe we'll see him on Saturday as well. Offensive line at left tackle. Oh boy, Eric Swenson and Anton Harrison are ORs. So by the way, there's 20 sets of ORs. And when I say by OR, it's like this guy or this guy at this position. So you can look at it two ways. Like there's a lot of depth or there's a lot of uncertainty. The way things have gone lately, especially on the defensive side of the football, it's depth. For the offensive line, look, if Eric Swenson is healthy now, I don't really think, we all make jokes and we all panic, I don't think he's that bad. I still would prefer Anton Harrison because I think he has the higher ceiling. I think he's going to be really good for OU down the road. But right now, that's what we got. Marquise, of course, at left. Robert Conjol is at center for now. There's a little scuttlebutt about Andrew Rain, whether he's going to be able to play or not. Like I said, I don't expect him to at this point, unless something drastically changes in the next couple days. Nothing too serious, apparently, so I think he should be back hopefully by next week, if not by Nebraska. We'll see. Chris Murray at right guard. I'm all for that. It sounds like there's good, you know, nothing but praise from him, but from Teddy and Gabe on their podcast. And Tyrese Robinson, they're going with him at right tackle. So, you know, I know there's a lot of questions about Wanya Morris. You know, they got him or Wanya at right now, which is weird because I thought Wanya was at left, but you know, I still think that they're still figuring things out in the O-line, and I'm a little nervous about that, but, you know, if you're going to figure it out, these next couple weeks are the weeks to figure it out before you go into conference play. So hopefully these are the weeks they figure it out, and then you go from there. Defense is not too shocking. Isaiah Thomas at DN, Perry Winfrey at nose guard, Ellison at D-tackle, Agwebu at Mike with Deshaun White, you know, as an OR. Let's see, Will, Brian Asamoah, or Deshaun White at Will. So, you know, these, you're going to see a lot of guys rotating in on the defense. Nick Benito, shock. He's your starting rush end. No questions there. But man, then you got Marcus Stripling, Caleb, and Clayton Smith at the bottom. I think Clayton Smith, who's like the big five-star rush end that we got, freshman. I think he was a little dinged up in the offseason. So I wouldn't expect a whole lot from him immediately. Just my two cents there. But I think, you know, we'll see how things go during the season, see if he gets in the rotation. And you got secondary DJ Graham at one corner. And then the other corner, you got Woody Washington. I mean, you got to play Woody Washington. Justin Harrington is in that rotation as well behind Woody. And safety, you got the usual suspects with Darren Turner, Yale, and Pat Fields. I know some people aren't going to be happy about that, but Key Lawrence right behind Darren Turner, Yale, and Justin Broyles, who's been getting a lot of praise lately. I think I mentioned last video. I know Justin Broyles can trigger a bunch of y'all. I understand that completely. But look, if he can have a Gabe Lynn type of senior season, you know, when he, like when Gabe went into that Sugar Bowl against Alabama and just basically had himself a good day, got himself an interception, I'll take that from Justin Broyles. not as your starter, but as a guy who can potentially, you know, make an impact at some point, just add some depth to the roster. I hopefully a couple years under Alex Grinch and learning from him will, you know, take him to that, you know, solid level that we've all been hoping he would be. And he's a good dude, too. He's a good dude. Everybody likes him. We just want him to play well, also. Also, real quick, just talk about, apparently the Big 12 is expanding. There's a lot of scuttlebutt about BYU and Cincinnati and Houston and UCF. It's like, my God, is this actually going to happen now? Because all these years with conference realignment, it's like, why don't they just add these teams? And along with Oklahoma, Texas. And it's just, they had to have their hand forced. They had to have the figurative gun to their head. Because we found out over the past 3 or 4 weeks how valuable these programs are to other conferences right now. And when you remove Oklahoma and Texas from the conversation, it turns out people aren't really too keen on picking apart. I thought Kansas would find a home. I really did. But now they have no choice but to band together, and now they're going to expand. So BYU could, you know, join like that because they're an independent. And they would probably be a football-only membership, I'm guessing, possibly. And then you have, Cincinnati and Houston. Houston probably should have been in the Big 12. They really should have. They would have. It was just a natural fit. But like, too many programs were like, no, we don't want to miss out on that Houston recruiting area and give that, you know, that school just like free 4 and 5 stars in that area for the next 20 years or so. Because like that was kind of happening under a certain head coach who used to be there. But yeah, so the way I look at it is this. If the Big 12 gets like nods from these schools, the quicker and easier the seamless transition this will be for Oklahoma and Texas to join the SEC. Maybe next year. I don't know. I'm still hoping. I'm hoping as a fan it will be next year. Hoping. Fingers crossed. All this. Fingers crossed. But at the end of the day, 23 seems likely, because you're not just involving OU leaving and OU Texas leaving the Big 12. You're involving these other schools leaving the American. I don't think they have a grant of rights in the American, because, Lord, why would you? Because why would you want to lock yourself into a mid-major? But just something to keep an eye on. So there you have it. Conference realignment updates, depth chart, football on Saturday. So with that being said, Boomer Sooner, y'all have a good one, and I'll catch you later.